sill pans can be made out of any one of a different number of materials. This happens to be a flexible wrap, this DuPont Flex Wrap. There are other manufacturers out there. You don't have to use DuPont. There's Grace, there's Protector Wrap, there's a whole bunch of different good quality peel and stick membranes out there. I do like the flexible ones because it allows us to form these things. You can also use a sill pan that's fabricated out of a solid. Am I putting you guys to sleep? I'm sorry. I can start throwing stuff back. You want more pencils? What do I have to pay you to stay awake? You can also use a rigid sill pan. Aster pan is one of them. It's a PVC pan. You can break form one out of aluminum. You break form one out of galvanized, out of copper. I've seen lead sill pans. Keep in mind, if you use a metal sill pan, you have to somehow create a thermal break, because it is a thermal bridge between the exterior and the interior, or vice versa. I've seen frost form on metal sill pans during the dead of winter in some areas, in very cold areas. It's another reason I like the peel and stick membrane. They're far more forgiving, in my mind, than metal sill pans are. Plus, the only thing I need to make them is the material itself and utility knife. They go in very easily. You'll notice this particular product has a two-part release paper. I'm not going to release the outermost piece. We're going to leave that in place for the time being. I'm only going to take this piece, and this is going to be a challenge. I said this earlier when I was doing this with the window. This is something that usually takes me a few minutes to do accurately when I'm not wearing a microphone and I'm not upside down and backwards and talking to 30 or 40 people. So bear with me. This stuff is tenacious. You don't want to stick it to itself. You'll never get it apart. You're going to throw the piece away. See how sticky it is. Here's how we work it. We're going to bring it in the opening. We're going to make sure we have enough room for an upturned leg about 3 or 4 inches high above the sill itself. We're going to lay it in place. And by the way, I know this is a little bit too narrow. You all can see that it's not completely covering the sill. I'm all right with that because I can take another piece of peel and stick and I can add a piece to it.